Dude, I don't.
All right, everyone.
Wrong sticker. That won't stick.
All right, everyone.
I can't believe the man saved my mind for all eternity. But then the only thing he gives me to do is watch boring TV shows.
That won't stick.
Captain Squidgy, how will we ever get to the picnic now?
No worries, Mr. Worrywart. We have Squidgy powers on our side.
Oh, yeah, obviously. I keep forgetting about those. Oh, yeah, let's use Squidgy powers.
Oh, wow, Captain Squishy looks just like the toy I made for the man some 30 years ago. Of course, he was just the boy then, but he loved that doll to bits.
Dearie, would you look at this photo? Why, when the man was just a wee lad, he would not go to the bathroom. He was afraid he'd fall in the toilet. But then when this doll appeared, he'd spend all his time in there. He named his doll Poopy. Did you know that? He was such a cute kid, sitting on the toilet every chance he got.
Excuse me, those aren't personal stories.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big dummy. Staying up here all the time, cleaning up after you, ensuring optimum efficiency of this space station. I'm just a big dummy.
You show embarrassing photos to strange women.
You'd prefer it if I didn't? You'd prefer it if I never did it again?
Yes.
Well, I'm not willing to do that. Your photos are adorable, and I will share them until the day I die.
Well then, I wish you'd hurry that up.
Oh, you'd say such a thing? You'd wish that your only mother who brought you into this world would die?
Come on, Mom.
No, you said it. Far be it for me to stand in the way of my son's wishes.
Self-destruct initiated. 120 seconds remaining.
Come on, Mom. Stop goofing around.
117 seconds remaining.
Mom.
115 seconds remaining.
Darn it.
Hey, you're safe.
Yeah? I'm not, like, dumb. I can escape as good as y'all.
I'm really glad, sweetie.
That's the good news. The bad news is that this station will explode in less than 2 minutes. Self-destruct.
We could call my friends for a ride. If only we had an intergalactic ultra phone.
And let me guess, those aren't available on Earth.
Nope.
Wait, I've got a great idea. What if I just think about an intergalactic ultra phone, then you could grab it out of my thoughts?
Whoa.
That's just crazy enough to work.
Where were we?
Okay, here goes. Well, stick some stuff in there. Maybe it'll turn into a phone.
Wrong sticker.
Okay, we got the phone. Now we just need to fire it into space.
What? We need to fire it into space? And you're just mentioning this now?
I'm sorry, I thought it was obvious. You know of any intergalactic ultra phones that work differently?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
I can't believe you'd say things like this to your own mother. Now, where were we?
Why did I put the self-destruct under computer control? And why did I digitize my mother's brain and put it into a computer? Why did I make this series of crazy choices?
This is no big deal. I'm sure there's a backup of me somewhere. 8, 7, 6. Oh, sure, it's no problem for me to blow myself up. You see, my only son doesn't care about all I do for him. So obvious.
Hello, Intergalactic Space Cab Service. Where can I pick you up?
Coordinates 352-222-452 Cedar Prime Sector.
Whoa. Is that Earth? There'll be an extra cleaning charge of 8,000 buckazoids to get there, buddy.
It's fine. Can you step on it, please?
No problem. We'll be there in, best estimate I can give you is 15 seconds.
15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10,
hey,
9,
Hey, are these guys
eight,
usually,
seven,
reliable?
Six, five,
kinda.
4, 3, 2, 1, 0.5, 0.4, 0.3. You know what? I don't think you actually care about me at all. I think you might actually be a jerk.
We're headed to Earth. Get us out of here.
You got it, buddy.
0.2, 0.1.
Real talk, the man. You make me wish I never got my consciousness downloaded into a space station computer. But now, as I look back on my life, I have this many regrets. Zero.
I was only screaming to get you guys to stop screaming. Anyway, here we are. Enjoy the rest of your evening, folks.
Well, I guess this is it. Thanks for saving me, guys. I can get to my home planet now. It's pretty cool there. Every night is buy one, get one free pizza night.
Every night?
We, eat a lot of pizza.
This was, memorable.
Nuh-uh. We're hugging this out.
Meter's running, buddy.
Oh, jeez, right. Okay, stay cool, you guys.
Where to?
Planet Spacetopia, by way of Planet Smooch Time.
Oh, sweet, I love Planet Smoochy Times. Even the traffic cops are friendly there. A little too friendly, now that I think about it.
That? Oh, that was a really long day.
You read my mind.
Really?
To send you a quick note, just to let you know I really had a great time hanging out. Both on your planet, and particularly in your bot. Both were not nearly as dirty as I've been told to expect. We had fun, didn't we? Let's do it again sometime. Come visit me as soon as your people invent interstellar travel, okay? Peace out. Oh, one more thing. I did a quick check when I got here, and I may have left a little something inside your head at some point. It's no big deal. And I know you'll be able to take really good care of it. Daddy?
Arlene!
I woke up this morning with the sundown shining in. I found my mind in a brown paper bag, but then I tripped on a cloud and fell 8 miles high. I tore my mind on a jagged sky. I just dropped in. See what condition my condition was in.
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah, what condition my condition was in.
I pushed my soul in a deep dark hole and then I followed it in. I watched myself crawling out as I was crawling in. I got up so tight I couldn't unwind. I saw so much I broke my mind. I just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in. Left the road and blew out my mind.